Dear students, after calculating the ground state terms for atoms and molecules, now in this lecture we will calculate the ground state terms for diatomic molecules. Before starting the calculations regarding the ground state terms for diatomic molecules, first we have to study about the quantum numbers. So quantum numbers for diatomic molecules, as we have already learnt the quantum numbers, new quantum numbers for the calculation of ground state terms of atoms and molecules. So in case of atoms or molecules, in case of atomic terms, we have already studied that L is the quantum number. It is total angular orbital momentum quantum number. So if we add orbital quantum number of each electron, then we will get this L, capital L. So this is for atomic term. For the calculation of atomic term, L is used. So if L is equal to 0, 1, 2 or 3, then the term will be S, P, D or F. Likewise, in case of diatomic molecules, orbital angular momentum quantum number can be denoted by lambda. So lambda, it is orbital angular momentum quantum number for diatomic molecules, and its value may be 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So if it is 0, then we represent the term as sigma. If it is 1, then the term is pi. If it is 2, then it is delta. And if it is 3, then the term will be eta. So like if L is 0, then the term was S. So in case of diatomic molecule, this L is replaced by this lambda. So if lambda is 0, then the state will be sigma. Then next quantum number for calculating the ground state term is S. So S in case of atomic term and in case of diatomic term. So in case of diatomic term, the spin angular momentum quantum number is denoted by capital S. And if the value of this S will be helpful in calculating the multiplicity of any term. While this lambda, it will gives about an idea of this term. What will be the term that will be denoted by this lambda, and what will be the multiplicity of that term, that will be denoted by this S. So S is in atomic term as well as in diatomic term, it is same. The third quantum number in case of atomic terms was J, that is total angular quantum number, that is L plus S, that is the value that lies from L plus S to L minus S. In this case, this total angular momentum quantum number in case of diatomic molecule, it is represented by omega, and omega is equals to the orbital quantum number and this spin quantum number. So if we add both of this can be denoted by this S. The sigma is S. So lambda plus S is equal to omega. So this is similar to the J values as in case of atomic terms. So we have studied three new quantum numbers, that are lambda. Lambda which define the term. What will be the term? The value of lambda will define the term. Then S. S will define the multiplicity. So if lambda is greater than S, then the values for multiplicity will be 2s plus 1. The 2s plus 1 will be the multiplicity. So then the third quantum number is omega. Omega is total angular momentum quantum number, which can be calculated if we know lambda and S. S may also be represented by sigma. There are three types of quantum numbers for atoms. So in case of atoms, there are L, S and J. total orbital angular quantum number, total spin angular quantum number, and total angular quantum number. Here also, in case of diatomic molecule, there are three quantum numbers, lambda, s, and omega. Lambda is the total orbital angular momentum quantum number, total spin angular momentum quantum number, and total angular momentum quantum number. So three new quantum numbers, they are used for determination or for calculation of ground state term of diatomic molecules. Now the other point is that the terms or states, they can be labeled as G or U at the subscript of the term. G or U means symmetric or anti-symmetric with respect to center of symmetry. We have already used these two subscript labels in the previous in the ground state terms of transition metal complexes as well as in the atomic terms. The other point is that states or terms can also be labeled as plus or minus. Plus or minus means symmetric with respect to plane of symmetry or asymmetric with respect to plane of symmetry. In case of atomic terms, we have used 1 and 2. In place of plus and minus, we have used 1 or 2, like T1G, T2G, A1G, A2G, or EG, G. But T1G, 1 and 2, they represent plus and minus in case of diatomic molecules. There are three types of molecular orbitals in diatomic molecules: sigma, pi, and eta. This point is to be remembered that sigma, pi, and eta are three types of molecular orbitals present in diatomic molecules. Then if the electrons lies in different orbitals, so if different orbitals, that means they are unpaired. So when they are present in different orbitals, then the multiplication of G level and G level is equals to G. G and U multiplied to give the U level, and U when they multiply, they will give the G level. So all these points, they are useful in determining or calculating the ground state term of diatomic molecule. A ground state term can be defined or can be generalized or can be shown with the help of this representation. This is the value of lambda. Here in superscript, it is 2s plus 1. This is multiplicity. Plus and minus sign should be here at superscript position of lambda. And omega will be at the subscript, or G or U should also be at the subscript of this lambda. In case of diatomic molecule, this is the representation of a term symbol. And for atomic term, this is the representation of a term symbol, that is the value of L. Here the 2s plus 1, that is multiplicity. Here the total angular momentum quantum number, J. So the representation is similar, but here a new thing is that here we use plus or minus sign in case of sigma term, and G or U in case of homonuclear species. In case of heteronuclear species, we will not use this G or U because there is no center of symmetry in heteronuclear diatomic molecule. So we use this G or U in case of only homonuclear diatomic molecules, and plus and minus sign will be used only with sigma term. These are the quantum numbers for molecular orbitals in linear diatomic molecules. So because we are going to calculate the ground state term for diatomic molecules through their molecular orbital configuration, so we have to have a knowledge of molecular orbital quantum numbers for molecular orbitals. So if molecular, there are, we have already discussed that there are three types of molecular orbitals for diatomic molecules, that is sigma, pi, and delta. And the ML values for these three molecular orbitals are, for sigma it is 0, for pi it is plus 1 and minus 1, and for delta it is plus 2 and minus 2. Atomic orbitals which overlap to form sigma molecular orbitals, they include s, pz and dz square. They may form the sigma type of bonding. Then pi bond is formed, can be formed by px, py orbitals or dxz or dyz orbitals. Then delta molecular orbitals can be formed by the linear combination of dxy and dx square y square orbital. So the ml value for this is 0. It means only it is singly degenerate. This molecular orbital is singly degenerate. Two electrons can be accommodate in this molecular orbital. In case of pi orbitals, there are always two pi orbitals. So in two pi orbitals, four electrons can be accommodated. So for two pi orbitals, one has the ml value of plus 1 and another will have the ml values of minus 1. In case of delta, there are again two orbitals which of which one has the ml value of plus 2 and other will have the ml value of plus minus 2. So this lambda will become 0 for sigma molecular orbital, 1 for pi orbital, because it is from plus 1 to minus 1, so lambda will be, L will be 1. For delta, L will be 2. So if lambda is 0, then the term will be sigma, we have already discussed. If lambda is 1, then the term will be pi, and if lambda is 2, then the term will be delta. So we can show with the help of this that in case of s orbital, this value of ml will be 0, sigma. It will form sigma. In case of pz, it can also form sigma bond. So its ml value is 0. And in case of dz square, its ml value is again 0. The orbitals which can form pi bond, they are px and py. Px and Py, they have plus 1 and minus 1 ml values, and delta bond with delta molecular orbital will be formed by dx square and dxy. So dxy and dx square y square, they have ml values plus 2 and minus 2. So on the basis of ml values, we can determine the value of lambda, and with the help of lambda, we can give a term symbol to that particular configuration. So if lambda is 0, then term will be sigma. If it is 1, then it is pi. If it is 2, then the term will be delta. With the help of this example H2 molecule, so this is a homonuclear diatomic molecule. So in case of H2 molecule, the MO configuration of H2 is 1 sigma G2. Two electrons are present in sigma G molecular orbitals. So 2 are present in sigma G. We already know that the lambda value for sigma orbital is 0. So if the molecular orbital is sigma, then lambda value will be 0. Lambda is 0. And there are 2 electrons in one orbital. So one will have the upward spin and other will have the downward spin. So one have plus half spin and other will have minus half spin. So S will becomes equals to 0. Now we can represent the term. Again, we know that the term can be represented by this lambda 2s plus 1 and then here g or u and here plus or minus sign. So if lambda is equal to 0, we know the term symbol will be sigma. So it is sigma because s is equal to 0. So 2s plus 1 is equal to 1. It is singlet state and it is g-rayed orbital. It is denoted by g-rayed. This orbital is g-rayed. Both electrons are present in g-rayed. So the symbol with the label will be G here. So the ground state term will be 1 sigma plus G. This is the ground state term for H2 molecule. For B2 molecule, the molecular orbital configuration is 2 sigma U2 and 1 pi U2. So 2 electrons are present in pi U2 type orbital. So these two electrons, there are two electrons, they can be arranged like this. Both the electrons may be present here or may be present here, or one electron may be present here or one electron may be present here. So we already have discussed that pi orbitals, they have two values of ml, one is plus 1 and other is minus 1. So we already know that the ground state term will be that state which have the maximum number of unpaired electrons. So this state is having the maximum number of unpaired electrons. These are the paired electrons. So this will not help of in calculating ground state term. So we have to calculate the ground state term with the help of this configuration. So in case of, because this is pi u, so this orbital is u, this orbital is also u. This is pi u, this is pi u. So one electron is present in u, one electron is present in u. If we multiply these two, then we will get the product will be g. So the term will be labeled by g at the subscript. Now, for these two electrons, lambda will be equals to 0 because ml value plus 1 minus 1. So it will equals to 0. S will equals to 1 because maximum spin unpaired electron, these are unpaired electrons, so spin will be on the upward direction, so their spin plus half is equal to 1. So due to this lambda is equal to 0, the term symbol will be sigma. Then S is equal to 1, then 2S plus 1 is equal to 3. Now it is G because the product of U and U is G, so term will denoted by G, and because it is a pi u orbital, so the sign will be negative with this, because for sigma orbital we will give positive sign, and for pi orbital, p orbitals, we have to give this negative sign. So the ground state term will be 3 sigma g minus. For C2 molecule, the electronic configuration, the molecular orbital configuration is the last electron, they goes to 1 pi u 4, so 4 electrons are present in pi u. So pi u, 4 electrons are present in pi u. This has u level, this has u level, so multiplication will be g. This has plus 1, this has minus 1 ml value, so total l value or lambda value will be 0. Or are paired electrons, so s will equals to 0. So due to this, the term will be sigma. This is equal to 0, so this multiplicity becomes 1. Because this is pi u orbital, so this has minus sign and this will be g. So the ground state term for this C2 molecule will be 1 sigma g minus. For O2 molecule, the molecular orbital configuration is 2 pi g2. So 2 electrons, they are present in pi g orbital. So they may be paired or they may be unpaired. So this is the configuration that will be helpful in calculating the ground state term. So this is G and this is G. This is represented by G. And this has plus 1 ml value. This will have minus 1 ml value. G into G is equal to G. So if these two electrons, they have the same spin, then lambda value will equals to 0. Lambda value equals to 0 because plus 1 and minus 1 is equal to 0. Then these electron has the same spin, so s will equals to 1. And then so at subscript we will use g for pi value because it is pi orbital, p orbital, so we will use the minus sign. So the ground state term will be sigma 3 sigma g minus. So this will be the ground state term for the O2 molecule. For in case of a heteronuclear diatomic molecule, G or U are not used. The other calculations are similar. So in case of CO molecule, the molecular orbital configuration is like this. And the electrons, the last electrons, they are present in 3 sigma G2. So G, sigma. Sigma means it is G rate. It can accommodate only 2 electrons. So for sigma orbital, value of delta will be 0. So it is 0. Like L is equal to 0 for S orbital, lambda will be 0 for this sigma orbital. Then there are 2 electrons which are paired electrons, so S will equals to 0. Due to this, lambda is equal to 0, the term symbol will be sigma. Due to this, S is equal to 0, the multiplicity will be 1. And because this is sigma orbital, so it is plus, and G will not used for this term symbol. So the ground state term will be 1 sigma plus. So for heteronuclear species, G or U cannot be denoted. So the ground state term is 1 sigma plus. One note is there that sigma minus state arises only when two electrons with parallel spins are present in pi or delta orbitals. So if in pi or delta orbitals there are two electrons with the same spin, parallel spin, then only this minus sign will be represented. So most of the cases the state is sigma plus, but in case of pi square or delta square they are having this parallel spin, the state is 3 sigma minus. So in these two cases only the sigma state will be minus. You can note down or you can take the screenshot of this particular table. This is the gist of the ground state term of different homonuclear and heteronuclear diatomic molecules. If you have taken the screenshot, then I can again discuss one by one. For H2 molecule, the molecular orbital configuration, the last electrons, for the largest electron it is 1 sigma G2. Then for sigma orbital, lambda is equal to 0. For 2 electrons, they are paired, so S will equals to 0. The ground state term will be, if it is 0, then this is sigma 0 S, then multiplicity will be 1. This is G orbital, so this will have G, and this has plus sign because this is S orbital. This includes the symmetric orbitals. Then in case of Li2, the electrons are present in 2 sigma U2. So again, this has lambda is equal to 0 and S will equals to 0 because these are paired electrons. Then the state will be sigma. Due to this, it will be plus 1. So both have the similar type of ground states. Because these two electrons, they are present in U orbitals. So this will become equal to U. So in case of B2, the configuration is pi U2, 1 pi U2. So the ground state will be 3 sigma minus G. Likewise, in case of CO, if we'll see the heteronuclear molecule, so we will see that the ground state configuration is 3 sigma G2. So sigma, so due to this sigma it is 0, this lambda will be equals to 0. Due to the two electrons present in the same orbital, they will have the opposite spin, so this will equals to 0. Then the state is sigma. Due to S is equal to 0, so this will be having the multiplicity of 1. Due to sigma, it is plus. No G or U used for these terms. In case of NO, the configuration is 2 pi G1. So for 2 pi G1, so for pi orbital, this lambda is 1. Then for 1 electron, the S will be half. So because this S is half, so this multiplicity will be 2. Because this is, this orbital is having, this lambda is equal to 1, so the state will be, the term will be pi. So the term will be 2 pi. No plus or minus sign will be used. No G or U will be used for this heteronuclear species because it is pi orbital. So we cannot use plus or minus sign with this ground state term. Now we will discuss the selection rules for diatomic molecules. So there are, in each spectroscopy there are some selection rules to discuss the spectra of particular species. So in case of diatomic molecules also there are certain selection rules. If the transitions follow that selection rules, then the transitions will be allowed, and if they not follow those rules, then they are forbidden transitions. So the first rule of the selection rule of electronic transitions in diatomic molecule is that delta lambda should be equal to 0 or plus minus 1, then the transitions will be allowed. Allowed transition means they will be the intense transitions. So if transition is taking from place from sigma to sigma, pi to sigma, pi to pi, delta to pi, in case of sigma the value of lambda is 0 0, so the difference will be 0. From this pi is 1 and this is 0, so this difference is 1, this is 0, and this difference is again 1, it is 2 and it is 1. So these transitions, if electron transit from sigma to sigma, pi to sigma, pi to pi, or delta to pi, then these are allowed transitions. Or if the transitions are taking place from sigma, this delta to sigma, it has the lambda value of 2 and it has 0, so the difference is 2. These kind of transitions, they are forbidden type transitions. So only the transitions which have delta lambda value is equal to 0 or plus minus 1, they are allowed transitions. In case of other selection rule, that is related to delta S. So it is spin selection type rule for diatomic molecule. Spin selection rules, that is also, we have also studied for transition metal complexes. There are selection rule for allowed and forbidden transition. Similarly, here also there is spin selection rule, and delta S should be equal to 0. So multiplicity of transitions should remain the same as that in case of transition metal complexes. So multiplicity should remain the same. As we have already seen that the transitions were taking place from, in case of transition metal complexes, they are taking place from same multiplicity term to same multiplicity term. So transitions are taking place from two multiplicity to two multiplicity. So likewise, in this case also, the multiplicity of the transitions should remain the same. The third rule for diatomic molecules is that for sigma-sigma transitions, actually there are two types of terms, two levels are there, plus minus sign and GU sign. So in case of sigma-sigma transitions, if plus to plus transition, minus to minus transitions takes place, then these are allowed transitions. So like these transitions, these are from plus sigma U plus sigma G plus. So these transitions are allowed transition because these are from plus plus to plus. So in this case, this has no charge, but this has plus. So these kind of transitions are allowed due to some other reasons. So plus to plus transitions are allowed transition, but due to this G, these are not allowed transitions. Okay, so these are plus to plus are allowed, minus to minus are allowed, plus to minus are forbidden, minus to plus are forbidden. And other rule is that G to U and U to G transitions are allowed. I think this we have already discussed in the transition metal complexes, that is Lappert selection rule type rule, that from same parity transitions, they are not allowed transition in case of transition metal complexes. But here U to U, G to G transitions are also not allowed. They are forbidden transitions. This is same to the that of the Lappert transition, Lappert selection rule in the case of transition metal complexes. So from G to U, it is allowed. From U to G, it is allowed. So in these transitions, if we see these transitions are from G to G. G to G transitions are not allowed because they are having the same parity. U to U transitions are not allowed because they are having the same parity. But U to G transitions are allowed transitions. They are plus to plus transitions also, U to G transitions also. So these are allowed transitions, and these are also allowed transition because these transitions are taking place from U to G. So these are the selection rules for diatomic molecules.